everyone, Tim here from Everyday Tactical Vids, and today we're taking a look at a fixed blade from Schrade. This is the Schrade SCHF33. Cool looking knife. I've nicknamed it the Bulldog already. It's just kind of what came to mind when I first took it out of the box. This is going to be available at the end of 2014 and into 2015, and let's give you some information about the blade. So when it comes to length, you're looking at about 9 inches from end to end, your blade length. When it comes to the actual cutting portion of your blade, is going to be close to 5 inches because you got about 4 inches here and then another inch on the front of that tanto shaped blade. Your total metal portion of the blade other than your handle is about 4.5 inches, and then you have another 4.5 inches of your handle there. This is a full tang knife, meaning that the metal is going to run from the tip of the blade all the way to the end of the handle. There's no exposed pommel here and also no lanyard hole. You do have a few different cutouts for your fingers. You've got a cutout here and then two here. I'll show you when I hold it in a moment, but for me, this one's quite usable and my hand just kind of, my fingers fall on top essentially of those two grooves. You do have a finger guard here and that's quite comfortable. There is jimping on the top on your little thumb ramp here. I find the way I hold it, I actually end up choking up, so my hand is a little bit up here on the top on the spine of the blade. This is a recurve blade, not a very steep recurve, but there is a recurve there compared to some of their other knives. This is mild on the recurve scale. Some of the other ones have a really significant angle on their blades when it comes to their recurve style. This is a tanto blade, so it's gonna be good for piercing. And then you have a shorter portion of blade here and then another portion down on this section as well. Here's what it looks like to hold the blade in kind of the classic style you would assume based on the ergonomics of the knife. So you've got your thumb here on this thumb ramp with the jimping. My first finger falls into this groove. You're not going to really put your fingertips into these two grooves here, but it'll end up like this in your hand. So that'll be good for stabbing. You can do some cutting with that. Obviously quite comfortable that way. But the other idea for me generally when I hold a knife like this is I'm going to end up choking up like this and putting my thumb up on top on the spine of the blade. And that just feels more secure for me to do any kind of work with it. You can remove these two slabs on the handle if you want to do so. 1, 2, 3, and then 4, 5, 6 as far as these bolts. What they usually do is that they're bolted on and then there's some sort of epoxy that they use to attach it to the metal in the handle here. So if you want to take it off, it's probably going to be a bit of work, but it is certainly doable for this knife. Here's what it looks like in the Kydex sheath. You can see you have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 different grommet holes, and then 1, 2, 3, 4 different slots. So lots of options when it comes to, you know, using paracord to attach it, or if you want to run some webbing through this, attach it to molly gear, attach it to a pack, whatever the case may be. You do have this loop here to run your belt through that. This is not adjustable, so you know, you're basically gonna run it with the tip down. I guess you could try to run it with the tip up, you know, if you wanted to do that, a little bit awkward. The other major challenge if you run it tip up is this. So the retention on the sheath, not great. That's something I'll address with Schrade and let them know. So maybe before this knife comes out, end of 2014, 2015, they'll make some adjustments there. Simple thing they could do is just put some you know, some bolts or some screws there so you could tighten that down a little bit. If you run it tip down, you know, like so, and it's in your pack or on your belt, whatever it is, shouldn't be an issue. But in general, if you're gonna have a Kydex sheath, you want it to secure in very firmly. So that's definitely something to be aware of for this knife and the sheath together. Let's talk about applications for the Schrade SCHF33. A lot of people, when they see a fixed blade knife, they immediately think that's a wilderness survival knife or a bushcraft knife or a camping knife. You could certainly use this knife in all three of those different settings, but I think there are better options out there. Even Schrade makes better options for each of those different types of applications. Is this a tactical knife? It's probably built to be kind of something in that direction, but because of the sheath and the retention issue, I wouldn't be using it in a tactical situation if I was law enforcement, military, something like that. Certainly until they got that done, and then I would want to really test it and use it to make sure that it was durable to be used in that type of situation. For me, I would say when I look at this knife, I think it's a fixed blade utility knife. So something I can keep in the trunk of my car, keep around the house when I need, you know, a strong fixed blade to do some aggressive work with. And it's just got a nice size for that. The proportion of handle to blade is almost exactly the same. You know, it's even, so I like that for kind of general just utility use. This recurve style is also good for cutting cordage, so rope, you know, twine, anything like that. It's also because of that recurve, it's made to draw material in when it cuts, so that's going to be good for cutting free hanging material, something that's hanging maybe on one end and is secured on the other end. So, you know, in an outdoor setting, maybe vine or something that's overgrown in your yard, you could certainly use this in that type of setting quite effectively. Now, most of the time when I do a knife review, I take it out and talk about, you know, the specs and the information when I'm here in the studio, and then I take it outside and cut some things with it, you know, do some batoning, make some feather sticks, different things like that. This one, however, is going right into my wife's emergency car kit in the back of her minivan, so I don't want to beat this thing up too much. I want to keep it in good condition so it's ready for her if she needs to use it. That will tell you something about my trust in this blade, even having not used it a ton. I'm pretty confident it's going to do the job as a fixed utility blade that I can keep in the back of her car for her to use, or if I'm driving her car, for me to use. Once again, this is the Schrade SCHF33. It'll be coming out the end of 2014 and into 2015. Thanks as always for checking out our videos here on YouTube. Please subscribe to Everyday Tactical Vids on YouTube if you haven't done so already. Like us on Facebook, follow us on Twitter, check us out on Instagram and Tumblr as well. Take care.